Hello everybody and welcome. Just like the Ford Focus Mark II, the Mark III also has a secret menu on its onboard computer, and I'm going to show you how to get access to it.
First of all, you keep pressing the OK button and then you turn the ignition on without starting the car. It will come up a test and that's the screen that you want.
Then by moving the cursor here on the steering wheel, you go through the different options that you see on the LCD display. The first one is the typical gauge sweep to make sure that they all work. Then you will have the LCD test panel, which tests if there are any dead pixels. Then the LED test to make sure that there are no blown bulbs on the instrument display. And then the chime test with all the different warnings sounds that your car produces. Then you have several functions like the economy mode gear shift. Not really sure what this is, but this is the hardware version of the vehicle. Then the software version, and then manufacturer date, which strangely in this car it doesn't come up. Then, and this is the very important one, no DTC. This will display any DTC codes your car might have. DTC stands for Diagnostic Trouble Codes. But the codes that come in here on the display are not exactly the same codes that are part of the ones that you will see from the OBD computer. These codes are different and they have to be decoded.
If you have any fault codes, the codes that you will see on the onboard computer screen are different from the ones that will come up on any OBD scanner that is plugged to the OBD port. That's because it's manufacturer-specific language, and what the OBD code readers do is to translate that language into the OBD protocol. Of course, there is a way to decode the code that comes on the on your onboard computer screen, and this is how it's done.
First of all, I would like to excuse my handwriting. So let's start from the principle that you've got these three codes coming up on your cluster screen. These codes do not correspond to OBD codes, so they have to be decoded to the corresponding OBD letter. And this is how you do the conversion. On F, it translates to OBD code U3. So I'm just going to put here U3. The C corresponds to the OBD letter U0, and E corresponds to the OBD letter U2. To convert it, you just replace this one with this one, take this off, and this one off, and then you also remove the last two digits of the code. These two, and these two. So this one will become U3006. This one will become U0415. And this one will become U2101. And these are the codes that are the correct for the OBD language. Of course, you will have to go online in order to get the exact meaning of these codes, because unfortunately these codes can mean different things on different cars. So your best friend is actually to Google these codes for your correct car, and then you will find out what they actually mean. Then, moving the cursor key once again, it will show the speedo gauge. Of course, it's not showing anything because the car is not moving. And the tacho gauge, of course, it shows zero because the engine is again not running. The odometer, because we know how many this in kilometers. And then fuel percentage, hex, and so on. These are all computer language. Fuel flow as well. Engine temperature, also in centigrades. It shows that the engine temperature, the coolant, is in 85 degrees centigrades.
battery 12 volts because the vehicle is stationary, but if the vehicle is running, it should show between 13 and 14 volts. Then distance to empty, 605 kilometers. Again, there's always a bit of a mix between the kilometers and miles. This is the average fuel economy. It's showing also in metric, 6.4 liters per 100 kilometers. And then the refuel, average fuel economy, I think it's 5.8 liters. Then there are some other audio, analog digital input, again, and we go back to the gauge sweep.
While the screen is on the test mode, you can still start up your engine by depressing the clutch and then go through the several different functions of the test mode, and then you will see that it will show things such as the fuel flow, the engine temperature going up, and also the revs and the amount of voltage that your car's battery is inputting. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you on next video. Take care.